swapping two variables does not depend on the type. Is an integral part of the language and has always been. In 1983, that was not that common, but you have a whole system, and task is really easy to use. You don't hesitate to put tasks in your program. So this is something I want to stress. We have seen that the compiler is doing the mapping from the high level to the low level. Sometimes you have requirements at the low level. Therefore, you can specify the exact low level representation. Here I have a record. I can specify that what the Boolean called on is in word 0 and its range of bit 0 to 0, so it's 1 bit. That counts is range 1 to 7 and so on. So you specify the high level, you specify the low level. And the idea is that once you've done that, you continue to work at a high level. If you want to set a bit, you write, because it's an array of bits, mi.status of 3, colon equal false, high level, and you get an end with the correct mask at the low level. So for people who say, oh, I need to do bit fiddling, therefore I need a low-level language, the answer is no. You specify the low level, and still the compiler is still mapping the high level to the low level. You continue to work at a high level and get what you want at a low level. Okay, really low level, it's easy to access memory. We have packages that allow you to write directly in memory. That's not a problem. You can include machine code. You can handle interrupt. All these features are provided. But the question is, if it's low level, it must be stated clearly. Because these features are provided by packages, you must name the package on top of your unit, and therefore the reader of your program will know that this is accessing low level. Okay? We don't want some dirty tricks under the carpet. So I mentioned the special needs annex. Here are the topics: system programming, real-time, distributed system, information system, numerics, and safety and security annex, now named high reliability annex. So it's really portable, and there are checks that there is a validation suite to make sure that compilers implement exactly the same language. And believe me, I sometimes write code on my laptop in the tram on a Windows system. I then copy that to Linux, and I don't even check on Linux. If it works on one system, it's the same thing on the other. So the free compiler is called NAT. It has excellent error messages, but I have few time left, so I have to hurry a little bit. Many components, and Ada is one of the, I don't think there are many languages who took care to define how to interface with other languages. Both ways, you can call other languages from Ada, and Ada can be called from other languages. This means that every available library that you are used to can also be used in Ada. So, conclusion, almost in time. You think that I would tell you, oh, use Ada. No, I won't tell you that, because I think you are grown-ups and you are free to do whatever you want. No, I would simply advise you to try Ada. Give it a try. See what it means to have that higher level view where the compiler frees you from all low-level details and protects you. And believe me, when you start having that help from the compiler, it's hard to return to lower level languages. That's it. Do we have some time for a question? Yes?
Hardware now have relaxed synchronization primitives.
Sorry, the door is open.
Relaxed synchronization primitives for multiprocessor systems.
Well, synchronization is another issue, okay? There is many attempts, for example, to define atomic variables and low-level also synchronization mechanisms. You are right, and barriers and so on. This is being discussed for the next version of the language.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome. Excuse me?
I missed the end of the end because there was just someone asking something.
Thank you for the talk.
Okay.
It raised more questions than answers for me, and that's always very
important. That's what you are for.
Thank you for the presentation, and I have some questions.
Oh, yes. Just before all of you leave, there is some literature that you can pick up on the table offered by EDACORE. So there is not much, but if you want, you can. There is a booklet like Ada for the C++ programmer. Okay.
Can I be in French?
Sure.
Possible?
Oui, bah, okay. Pas de problème.
Merci beaucoup pour la présentation. Et je voulais moi, Ada, ça fait depuis très longtemps que je voudrais essayer, puisque j'ai essayé pas mal de langages, etc. Est-ce que vous avez une liste de 5-10 projets qu'on pourra réaliser, mais qui sont plutôt focus à Ada? Parce que moi, quand je vais essayer de mon langage, je vais sur HackerRank, mais de faire des algos autour des strings, etc., c'est vraiment pas le...
Oui, non, c'est pas drôle. Pour apprendre... Alors, déjà, il y a un truc qui est bien pour apprendre, c'est Rosetta Code.
Oui, ça fait partie des choses, mais est-ce que vous avez des mini-projets qui sont plus orientés sur l'utilité, enfin, je sais pas, d'ADA, peut-être?
Disons que, plus dans l'embarqué, bon, moi, je fais beaucoup de formation ADA, hein. Ouais. Donc, j'ai des exercices, mais un mini-projet du niveau du mini-projet, j'ai pas spécialement d'idées comme ça, ou alors...
Par exemple, un exercice qu'on réalise assez régulièrement quand on fait du langage fonctionnel, c'est d'écrire un compilateur. Parce que ça se marie assez bien. On a un AST à manipuler, un arbre, des transformations mathématiques, elles sont plutôt adaptées.
Alors là, on a un outil très puissant qui s'appelle Aziz. Ouais. C'est-à-dire que c'est une API qui permet d'accéder à tout l'arbre décoré du programme ADA. D'accord. En gros, le compilateur crache dans un fichier son arbre décoré. Et on a une API qui permet de le parcourir. Donc, j'écris des utilitaires qui utilisent ça, mais on navigue complètement dans l'AST. Enfin, c'est très agréable. Ça s'appelle Aziz, mais enfin, c'est pas très facile. Je le conseillerais pas pour un débutant. Hein.
Et des choses plutôt orientées, embarquées ou des choses du style.
Alors, il y a des tas. Alors, tu connais la BBC Card? C'est une petite carte, format carte de crédit, qui embarque un arme, des trucs. Ça vaut 15 euros, je crois. et à d'accord, fournit un environnement de développement pour ce truc-là.
D'accord.
Donc,
c'est comme la chaîne.
Ils ont fait ça pour les cours pédagogiques de la BBC en informatique.
D'accord. Okay.
Donc c'est vraiment pour que les gamins puissent s'acheter ça sur l'argent de poche. Et tu peux dire. Donc Fabien Chouteau d'Adaccord. Et je parlais de la carte BBC.
Ah oui, très bien.
Donc parce qu'il cherche un peu des petits projets pour jouer un petit peu avec le langage.
On a un blog. Okay. Blog. On a plein de petits projets.
D'accord, ok, super.